Oh, Michael Moore.
Have you met Michael Moore before?
No, now I have.
でも今日お会いできました。
あ、できたね。今日初めて。
Michael Moore じゃねえから。
Not Michael Moore.
あのアニメのあの緑色の。
じゃねえ。
I'm not sure. I don't think you were. I think you look very nice.
知らなかった。思いませんでしたよ。すごく可愛いです。
ああ、よかった。優しい。
あなたも可愛い。
You're very cute.Hey guys, this is Larissa, and today I'm going to be talking about lookism in Japan and my personal experience growing up in the Japanese culture and compared to the experience that I have now in England. So I came across with this video where Japanese comedian, he made a video about lookism and he was discussing about it with his guest. And sadly that video is deleted now, so I can'tput the link in the description. Yeah, after I watched it, I don't know, I was full of mixed emotions, mixed feelings, and I just, that triggered me with so much memories and experiences that I had in the past. There's so many things to cover about this topic, so let's just jump right into it. Okay, so what is lookism? Lookism is prejudice or discrimination on the grounds of a person's appearance. So basically, commenting negatively about someone's appearance and about their face feature or their body. And I'll be really, really honest, I've never been abused or bullied just because of how I look with my face feature or my body shape. But I have so many people around me that have been affected by it. I've also been affected by it just because I thought that way of thinking and commenting on someone's appearance were normal, and I will get back into it by commenting. So first of all, Japanese culture, all Japanese women naturally have low self-esteem, and having low self-esteem is regarded as good, that is regarded as being polite and being humble. It's quite normal to talk about someone else's appearance without any hesitation, like any hesitation. So even when you go up to a stranger and when you're introducing yourself, you do mention about, oh, you look so pretty, but not as like your outfits are pretty or your hair's pretty. It's more like, oh, your face is very pretty, or just anything about your face feature is quite normal. Also, another quite interesting culture about Japan is we have this contest in university. There's some contestants and you can vote for them who looks the prettiest, which is just like, it's more like, you know, Miss Universe, Mr. Universe. Do you have Mr. Universe? I'm not sure, but it's just that same idea where you vote for someone that you think that they look the prettiest or they look the most handsome. And I guess they're going to be the face of the university when they win. That really also shows that, I guess, the culture of obsession with appearances, like you have to look a certain way to be popular, to be famous, to be known from the public. And it's not only for the university, there's for high schools as well, there's for junior high school. I mean, if you want to do it, go for it, but me, I just personally think that it's just a bit, I don't know, like too excessive. But it's just that amount of obsession with people that looks pretty and people that has naturally good looking, it's just really crazy to me. And going back to the beginning of the video, I said I'm going to talk about the experience that I have here in England now. And again, like, I do like comparing cultures, and not in a way that which culture is better or worse. It's just interesting for me to see from different perspective and how people's mindset and I guess the society, the way of thinking changes so much. And I've also commented this on the video that I watched about the lookism, and it's deleted, but I screenshotted it because I think this is what I really stand for or what I believe in. So I basically commented in Japanese, but I mentioned about that I currently live in England and I just never really experienced people commenting about my appearance in the first place. If someone wants to compliment me they will comment about my hairstyle or about my makeup or my outfits, not for how I actually look, but how I dress up, how I style clothing and stuff. And I guess that's kind of normal here in this culture. And I also mentioned about my husband. He used to live in Japan as well. He's like naturally blonde and has like a, you know, bigger body, I guess, compared to, you know, Asian men. So when he was teaching in high school, all these like young students will go up to him and say like, oh, you're so ikemen, you're so muki muki, which means ikemen means like, oh, you're so handsome, muki muki means like you're so muscly and strong and that kind of stuff. I remember he was telling me that is so weird, it's so uncomfortable people talking about how I look. I explained it to him that there is no bad intention, like people are generally think that you are good looking and you are pretty, so like there is no bad intention to it. But I did agree to him that it is quite strange to just go up to a person and be like, oh my god, you're so good looking. But yeah, I remember he also mentioned that here in England, that talking about someone's appearances directly is taken as quite rude. Not rude, but it's just quite unnatural to just go up and talk to someone like, oh my gosh, you look really beautiful, or like, oh my gosh, you're so tall and you're skinny. Like, no one talks about that, because that's too personal, of course. And even the word that you say, oh my god, you look so skinny, maybe that person's intention is saying like in a good way, like, oh my gosh, you look like a model, for example. In Japanese culture, we tend to use the word skinny as in a good way. But of course, in so many people, they take it in a different way. Maybe that person is trying to gain weight, but then the person comment like, oh, you're so skinny, they don't take it in a positive way. So everyone takes the comments so differently. So talking about someone's weight or someone else's body shape, it's just not healthy at all. But again, that still exists in this Japanese culture. And yeah, in the comments, and going back to the comments, I basically mentioned that I'm not saying which culture is wrong or right or anything, but I guess especially in the UK, it's so international that there is no particular beauty standards can, you know, adapt to everybody. Everyone looks so different, like from different culture, different countries, different race. From that perspective, is you can't really comment, oh my gosh, you look pretty because you have this skin tone, or you have this hairstyle, you have this eye shape, because everyone's different. And I said that I do love the way of respecting that diversity and just people not, I guess, not bothering that much about other person's appearance. I think I really respect that. And comparing to Japanese culture, where people are obsessed with other people's appearance. Hi, so lookism itself is such a complicated topic and there's so many issues around here, but I found this interesting article, so I thought I would introduce it. So it says that nearly 20,000 women in Japan this week joined the hashtag Kutsu movement and signed an online petition demanding the Japanese government ban companies from requiring female employees to wear high heels on the job. Yumi Ishikawa, who started the drive, said now wanted to campaign against lookism, prejudice based on appearance, especially where it is seen as falling short of a narrow social definition of attractiveness. Hi, so I just wanted to mention that there are so many pressure in different social situations where especially women have to dress up in a certain way, talk in a certain way, and the prejudice against appearances exist in different social situations. But as in this article, I'm so glad to hear that there are so many Japanese women standing up to this issue and raising their voices, putting it out there, which is great. And I thought this movement plays such a big role, especially for Japanese women to feel comfortable to talk about this topic and to feel comfortable that they don't need to follow this social rules, which doesn't make sense in the first place. So yeah, I'm glad to see
all these movements and changes that's occurring. I thought it was really important to mention in this video, but I will link the article in the description so you can go and check it out after this video if you're interested. So yeah, let's go back to the video.
Alright, and another thing that kind of represents the lookism in Japan, and this, for this topic, I'm quite passionate about. And that's why I showed you in the beginning, I showed you this clip in the beginning of this video. But what happened is that there is this Japanese comedian on a TV show. She's quite popular, and the way she makes jokes and her comedy style is to make fun of herself. You'll be so surprised how many Japanese women, comedian especially, makes fun of their look and their faces or their body shape or body sizes. They will make fun of themselves, and people actually love that. Like, public actually find that funny. This particular clip, this is Ariana Grande, was on this TV show. So Japanese comedian, basically she makes fun of herself, and there's this guy that kind of like joined this comedy style to, I guess they're both intentions are not negative, like they just generally think that that's funny, like really. But yeah, they make fun of like, oh, she looks like Shrek, or she looks like this person. And then Ariana Grande is like, she's like, what are you talking about? Like, that's not really funny. Like, she didn't even laugh like for this joke. She didn't find it funny at all. And that really shows the differences between the cultures. Like, in Japanese culture, so normal, and people find it really funny to joke about people's appearances. That, whereas in, I guess, in Western country, that is taken as rude. And especially Ariana, I guess she doesn't take any, you know, BS about that. And I heard about this story as well, that when this TV show went, when they were on a break on this TV show, Ariana went up to this Japanese comedian and said that, like, no, like, you're actually really pretty and beautiful, please be confident. And that really shows like how, for Ariana's perspective, maybe she thought that people are bullying her, because, you know, it's not normal to joke about someone's appearances. But from a Japanese perspective, it is, again, it's quite taken as funny. And then, like, the thing what really frustrates me is that people need to know the impact that they can make through social medias and TV shows and stuff like that, because the young generations, the impressionable teenagers that watch that TV show and think, that's really funny, I can make joke about my friends' appearances, and they will just think that's normal. For me, I think it's quite irresponsible for especially comedians and TV personalities or just guests, whoever's on a public eye, normalize that. I think that's quite irresponsible, and I guess the culture plays a big role, especially into comedy style or the way of thinking and everything, really, that everything that I just talked about. But on a, just ending on a positive note, I've seen so many models, idols, just like all these influencers that are actually embracing their just natural beauty, and I love that. I love seeing just people being so confident of not just only how they look, but just like they just embrace who they are inside, not only the outside but the inside. And I think that's the quality, that's what makes you different from other people, and I love that. I hope that all these, again, impressionable teenagers especially, I hope that they don't feel the pressure or the need to change their whole look just because they feel like they need to, like they don't have to, like they're all beautiful. And I just wish that I could just, like, you know, just talk to them in person, be like, people who comment about your look and your appearances doesn't matter at all. It just matters. What really matters is how you think about yourself, not what other people think. Like, you need to take care of yourself, and you're the priority, not others' opinions. I just hope in the future that more natural beauty will be taken as beautiful, and people will stop commenting about people's appearances. Please. Alright, Now I've been filming for so long, I'm going to go crazy. So I'm going to finish it here. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and don't forget to thumbs up if you enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check my Instagram as usual, it's right here. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye!